The devastating fire in Gordon, Wisconsin, the fire hall with all its trucks and equipment has ironically itself gone up in flames.
Live from the WDIO broadcast studios, this is Eyewitness News at 10 on WDIO WIRT.
Good evening, I'm Darren Danielson. That fire burned the fire hall in the town of Gordon, Wisconsin. That's just about 45 minutes south of the Twin Ports. Our Maria Anderson was on the scene today. Maria, thankfully no one was hurt.
That's right, Darren. So some good news there, but the fire hall was a total loss. And one of the Gordon firefighters told us they had just finished a new addition and they were getting ready to sell one of their fire trucks to get a new one. But now they'll be starting from scratch.
It's pretty sad. I mean, it's definitely a big difference between 4 months ago and today.
The Gordon Fire Hall is hardly recognizable. It's now a charred building and outside the remains of what once were red fire trucks. It's a far cry from last May. During the Gurman Road fire, it was the command center for hundreds of first responders fighting the massive wildfire. Now the department has to start over.
We basically lost everything in the fire hall. We had 6 trucks, 2 engines, 2 tenders, and 2 brush trucks.
Chief Mike Chmielecki says around noon they heard reports of a structure fire at the fire hall. When they arrived, flames and smoke were already billowing out.
There were several small explosions coming from inside the building. We're assuming that was, you know, part of the equipment on the truck.
The chief says putting out the fire was difficult, partly because all of the Gordon firefighters' equipment was inside, and also the mutual aid departments had to get through those huge metal garage doors. The 15 Gordon firefighters couldn't help fight the fire without their equipment, but 4 local fire departments responded.
If something like this happens to one of us, it happens to all of us.
Keith Kessler with Douglas County Emergency Management is on hand to assist in recovery. He says fire departments across the state will help Gordon with any of their extra equipment, and in the meantime, local fire departments will help out with any calls.
Something like this is devastating not only to the department that owns it, but also to the neighbors. There's a lot of investment in volunteerism in this county.
Darren, no word on a cause yet, and the chief says the building was built in 1979 and it was up to code.
And you covered the Gurman Road fire for us, where it was just full of activity and people everywhere. How was that? How weird was that for you today to see it in that condition?
It was shocking. It was devastating. I mean, there were hundreds of first responders there, and you know, it's such a contrast.
Wow. All right, Maria, thank you very much. Meanwhile, 2 Wisconsin lawmakers are responding to that fire tonight. A joint statement from State Senator Bob Jauch and Representative Nick Milroy out tonight saying, quote, "We are saddened to learn of the fire that has destroyed the Gordon Fire Hall and resulted in the loss of the township's firefighting equipment," unquote. The statement goes on to say that they have contacted emergency management to talk about getting temporary equipment from other departments. And again, as Maria just told us, there will be firefighting services for that area as neighboring townships begin stepping in. And you can read that full statement from the politicians and see all of our coverage from today. Head over to our website, WDIO.com.